Hi guys, Squad here. Welcome back to another My Summer Car. Now, if you remember last time, we earned a lot of money. We got 9,300. We did a job down here for poop. We did two jobs for poop there. And we also brought a scrap car from, let's see, what was it? What, around about here-ish. We brought that to the mechanic in Lop, or Lopper, however you say it. We've got a lot of money, but we're really tired. We're going to have to go to sleep. If we look at the map, there is another poop job right there. Now, given that we're going to go and collect our parts tomorrow, and our parts come from the shop, which is here, we're going to go in the truck, so we can fill the truck up with fuel, put the parts in the back of the truck, they should fit, and then we can empty the poop, I haven't decided where, somewhere here, and then we can go and take that, and then another 1,200. Then we can come back, we're going to fill in the order form, order some more stuff, which we can't do. Actually, can we do it yet? I don't think we can. I don't trust that. I've not had a phone call yet about my original order. I don't know whether to risk taking another job or not. Whether to put another order in or not. I'm not 100% sure. Normally, you get a phone call. I think you normally get a phone call to say your parts have come in. I'll tell you what, let's go to sleep. Because what I don't want to do is create another order and it mess up my existing order. Because I'm not sure how the game works. That's assuming, of course, it posted our original order. Because it kind of swallowed it. I don't know. I just hope the order's gone through, otherwise I'm going to cry. Right, it's 4 a.m. What we'll do is we'll quickly save it. That'll advance the clock forward 2 hours, and then we can drive up to the town. So I'll do that, and then we'll carry on. Okay, I've saved it. Didn't feel a thing, did you? Right, let's look at the time. See, it's 6 o'clock now. Hungry and thirst. Okay, well, we're going to go to the town today, so it's no big deal if we get hungry or thirsty, because we can always sort ourselves out in the town. I'm not going to fill that order form in. I'm just going to get in the truck. Actually, what I might do is take that, and we'll get that filled up as well. Actually, this needs to go on the tractor, doesn't it? So let's, okay, don't do that. Let's do a couple of things here. Let's fill the tractor up, and then we'll head up to the town. That's what we shall do. Sorry for just changing my mind. I'm just trying to think things through. What's the best way to do things? Yeah, we've got plenty of space in the back. We've got some beer. We've got some food. We did have mosquito spray. Where the heck has that gone? Okay, we had mozzie spray here, and it kind of looks like we lost it. That's annoying. I remember it being trapped in the dashboard, though. I can't see it anymore. I'm thinking it fell out. Okay, never mind. We'll buy some more mozzie spray as well. So yeah, a few things to do. Let's put some lights on. So we'll be taking the highway today. The highway to hell. Just to make it a bit quicker. Those mailboxes on the corner, though, I am wondering if at some point he's going to use them for something. They have no use at the moment. There seems to be one for your house and one for the neighbour's house. But they're not actually used for anything currently. Okay, right. Let's leave the engine running. Let's put the parking brake on. Let's grab the canister. Let's open the door first. Grab the canister. Is it this side or this side? This side. So we'll flip that over, pop the lid. That's where you fill the tractor up, right there. Make sure you've got the diesel. And now that should fill up visibly compared to the truck. But even so, it's still pretty slow. You can see it just pixel by pixel filling up. Because driving the tractor all the way up to the fuel station is just not an option I want to consider. So we're always going to be filling it up with the jerry can. So it's definitely better to do it this way. But yeah, well, it's going to cost quite a few mark to fill up the truck and the jerry can. I think there's definitely an element of planning ahead with this game, you know? You've really got to think twice before you go anywhere. Like, have I got everything I need? Is there something else I can bring? Is there something else I can be doing? If I'm going up to town, you know, what do I need? Okay. Time to hit the road. Let's get centered. Make sure that's closed. And we're off. Yeah, if you notice on the fuel gauge, bottom left, we're getting down to, I don't know, maybe about a third on the tank now. So it's definitely time to fill it up. Because it does use quite a bit of fuel, particularly when it's fully loaded like this. It's pretty heavy right now, this thing. It's got 10,000 litres. So that's another 10 tonnes of sewage in the back. Well, probably more than 10 tonnes, actually. Actually, the rear axle was up for some reason. I think when I saved the game, it reset the axle as well. There's something useful about that and something annoying. Like, if your car battery runs out and then you save the game, come back in, it resets the battery. That's great. If you have a bag of shopping and it's in a lovely plastic bag and then you save the game and you load it back in, the bag has exploded and all the contents are on the floor. That's really annoying. And then there's the little things like that, like it doesn't remember the state of the axle switch that you had on, or whether you had the parking, like I set the parking brake when we pull up in the drive in the car, but when I get back in the car after a save, the parking brake is always off. So it doesn't remember the state that you left it in, it just kind of resets it. Maybe that's something he'll fix in the future. Oh boy. Oh boy, this is heavy. This is bouncing around. It's like trying to drive a cruise liner on wheels. It's super heavy. Doesn't want to go where I want it to go either. So yeah, I'm going to take a left here. And we're going to get onto the highway. Double check Scumbag's not here. She's not. So hopefully, I mean, if you're not playing this game, hopefully by now you're kind of getting used to the routes that I'm taking. When I very first started playing this game, oh my god. I was like, I had no idea where I was. The very first time I played it, I was like, what do? I was trying to get used to the interface. I got my car. Got my van, because my car was in just bits, literally. Got my van, I was like, how do you start this thing? You know, how do you drive? Let's map some keys. And then, of course, when I had worked that out, you know, I could see the thirst bar going up and the hunger bar going up. And I thought, okay, there's some food there. How do I eat that? Press F. Thirst bar. How the heck do I drink? Drink beer. Great. Now my head's swaying. What's going on? And then when I started to leave my little sort of housing estate, as it were, I'm coming down the road thinking, where does this go? Where does this dirt track go? And it was only when I found a map, I think, on Steam, like a map of the... But I had clocked the poster next to the telephone. I had clocked that was a map, but of course, wasn't really sure where I was on the map. It doesn't actually say, you know, you are here. it just shows you a map. So I had to kind of work it out. But then gradually, over time, I started to memorize the map and it all got a lot easier. But the very first time I played it, it was seriously confusing. Right, where do we empty the sewage, guys? Where do we empty the sewage? Now, do we annoy Greenpeace and empty it into the lake? Do we annoy religious folk out there and empty it onto the church steps? Do we annoy the mechanic and empty it onto his forecourt so he doesn't do any more jobs for us, maybe? Do we hope the police pull us over and then empty it onto the police? I like that idea, but that relies the police pulling us over. I tell you what, I'll make you a promise. On this journey here to the town, if the police pull us over, which they only have to be on the road, you have to stop anyway. If the police are present and pull me over, I will empty the sewage onto their car for the lols. Otherwise, I'm going to empty it in town. We could empty it onto the Wub car. We could empty it onto the shop. We could empty it into the MOT test centre, because I don't think we need him anymore. Let's see what happens when we get there. Let's see if we get there first. You never know with this game. Yeah, let's... if the police... The police will be our number one choice. Basically, any characters that annoy me. Like, the next thing I'd want to do... You know that green car? I'd like to get him... Like, push him against a tree and then just tip sewage on him. I'd like to do that. Trying to remember the route here. Oh yeah, I remember. There's a road that turns off, and it's not that one. It's the one after it. I remember. Actually, don't know. Will you turn off at this road here? I actually don't really know where it goes. I know it goes back to the dirt track, but I can't remember if there's anything significant there. Oh, it might be the. It might be the airport and the race and the rally track. I've not been there properly yet. We need to do that one day. We need to go to the airport bit. Is it an airport bit? I think so. Like a disused runway, I think. Which is, I think is to our right now. What's that there? Nothing. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh, we're drifting. We're drifting. Holy. Holy cow. My cheeks may have squeezed quite tightly then. Because the back end stepped out, the whole thing drifted, I turned in, and luckily the physics was decent enough that allowed me to catch it. That there. That, you see? We've not been up there yet. We need to go up there at some point. Man, I've never drifted a fully loaded sewage truck before. Ever done that? I've never done that. Yeah, so this is the bit of the lake where the dirt track doesn't go around, just this section here. That was actually quite fun thinking about it now, that drifting. If anything had come around the corner though. Okay, next turning is us, which should be very, very soon. Is this it? No. I love it. You see the sign hidden behind the tree? Like the really useful sign that said, like the town name, 1 kilometer. I'm actually getting a bit hungry and thirsty. I might have to buy, now we're off the highway, let's have a quick beer. Might actually buy some food while we're here and some mozzie spray. Alright, first thing I'm going to do is empty this thing. We didn't get the police one, unfortunately, so let's see, where can we go? Welcome. There's the MOT test centre. What's this yellow building here? Oh, it's Saturday. Look, it's rally day. It's the trials day. So if you want to do the Saturday rally trial, you come here to this guy. Okay, I'm not really sure what that is. Is that the church? I think it's the church, isn't it? Is he the one, guy that wants a job doing? No, he's not. He's the guy around here that wants a job. Wants the job. This one. But I can't take it yet because I'm full. So I need to empty. Alright. We could go for the lake. But I fancy this. Of course, we're going to get pretty dirty doing this. There's no real way of avoiding that, I don't think. Just hope we can actually get through, though. Okay, set the brake. Yeah, I'm not really sure. I think this is the church. I'm not 100%, to be honest. Let's try and get out of the way of this thing. Open the spill valve. Hi, yay, yay. Oh, that is disgusting. That is disgusting. Look at this. 10,000 litres all over the walls. Hang on. Let's make a slightly bigger mess. Let's move it forward a bit as well. Just paint the whole path. Paint the whole path brown. There we go. Oh, it's not really painted it brown, look. Right, let's try and close that. Now that is a stain. That is an... Look at this. We shall cross the threshold. Mind you don't slip. Alright. Fun over. It was either that or the lake. I think at some point the mechanic gives you a job to pour it onto the MOT test centre. But we've not had that job yet, so we've got to wait for him to ask us to do that. But that would be quite fun. Right, where's your, is it, where's yours, at the back there somewhere? I can't remember. Let's try about there. Every house is in a slightly different place, annoyingly. Oh, crikey, look at that, his is right at the front. I can hear wub wub. I guess it's Saturday, maybe it's time for him to play his music on the shop front. Oh, there's my mozzie spray. Hang on, there's my bottle. Look. We found it. Okay, we'll put that in there. Yo! We're here to not reverse far enough. Okay, we're kind of hoping this is going to work. Take the hose, pop it in. Hey, we're over here anyway. It's an easy 1200. And that's going to buy us a race wheel or something. Actually, this will pay for the fuel bill, to say the least. Pay for the shopping and the fuel bill, this will. And we're already here. We might as well. Oh, the mozzies are here already. Don't worry, bro. Just have a beer. Hello, sir. Could you maybe think about pulling up a chair for me next time? So that we can... So how's your day been? Is it good? Sorry, when you need to go... Oh, you haven't got any shoes on. What a shame. Or have you? No, he has. He has got shoes on. Might I just say, sir, that you hold that beer in a very strange way, and your fingers look like sausages. But apart from that, it's all good. As long as he pays me, I don't care. Okay, so when we've done this, we've done all the sewage jobs on the map so far. We just have to wait for them to sort of come back again, which will only happen by phone calls. Then we're going to drive up there, go to the shop, fill up on diesel, fill up the jerry can, get some shopping in. Hopefully pick up our ordered parts, which I really hope it took that order, otherwise I've got this horrible feeling that when I picked the envelope and I put it in the mailbox, it either accepted it or it pinged it off into infinity like it did my shopping bag that time. Listen, mate, I'm telling you now, if you don't pay me for this, I am going to tip it back on your drive here. I'm just saying. Oh, there we go. I thought that would get you to pay. Nice doing business with you. Glad you can see things my way. What is he saying? I love how they've all got slightly different voices. Okay. Look at this. We're getting good at this. We're getting real good at this. Almost like a pro. The thing is, you don't really need to put that silage cover back on either. Sewage cover. I wish I could stop calling it silage. You don't need to put that sewage cover back on, or septic tank cover, whatever you want to call it. Because when, like I say, when you save it, you'll just reset it anyway. But it feels right, you know? It feels right. Go on, get in. Wow, vehicle is so much lighter now. Won't be able to drift it anymore. Yeah, so he won't talk to us yet because we're not on our rally car or anything. So we'll just ignore him for now, but every Saturday they have that little rally thing on. Maybe we can do it on next Saturdays. Maybe we'll actually be good enough at that point. Who knows? Okay, you're coming with us. Wub wub. Okay, let's see. Diesel. Now, the only downside to filling up the truck is it does take a while. Like, filling this up is not a problem, but filling up the truck, I'm probably going to have to, I don't know, time-lapse the video on that one. Because it's a big old tank on that truck. I think from naught to empty, it's about... is it like 10 minutes, like real time? It's something crazy. Okay. Let's undo that. And I shall cut this so that you don't have to watch this. Welcome back. It's just finished. That took just over 4 minutes, almost 5 minutes to fill that up. Real time. Which is why I didn't make you sit and watch that. And all the time it's doing it, I had to listen to that in my right headpiece. That's what I mean about this game. It's not just mosquitoes. There's other trolley things as well. Right, we just haven't hit 10k. We're about to not hit 10k anymore.
Okay.
Yay! There's our order, which means the order did go through. So we're going to pay that. That's 2047. So our items will appear outside. Now I've got to pay the bill for the fuel, which is 1,000, guys, on the fuel. Think about that. All the jobs we've done. That's basically come out of the profit. Okay, that was weird. Right, one Mozzie spray. Don't need any beer. Let's go for a couple of sausage, a couple of those, a couple of those. Can't buy those. And we'll buy 4 bags of chips. So we'll buy one more beer. Do you read any stuff from here? No. Now, there is a plan, I think, to make allow you to make a Finnish alcoholic drink and sell it, I think. That's why all those all the yeast and sugar's there, but currently it doesn't do anything. Okay. Right, we'll pop that in there. Open this. Make sure everything's laid out how we want it. So beer at the back. Put that there. There's our parts. As you can see, they're not the big ones. The seats and the exhaust are massive. If you get those, you need the van, really. Okay, we're getting a little bit pecky, so I might have a snack on the thing. One of the things that's inside the truck, but not in the bag. So let's do that. Pop that there. Where's the food? There's the food. Better pizza and a beer. Pizza and a beer, guys. What a lunchtime Saturday that is, eh? Okay. We want to unbox these. We'll get them back first. And we'll unbox them when we get back. Because I find it's like Christmas. It's so exciting. Let's get that one. Is that music getting on your nerves yet? Never mind the mozzies. Two little boxes left. Oh, it's finished. Wait. It's repeated. And then that one. That, I believe, is everything. So put that in the footwell. There, like that. Shut the door, and we are good to go. Nice. So it's kind of a good thing that we earned another 1,200 because, you know, we spent 2,000 in bits, we spent 1,000 in fuel, and then a few hundred in bits of food. And we're down to 7k already. So I think the next job that I'd want to do would probably be the firewood because it pays the most. And it's repeatable. Because I want to order some more parts, really. Which essentially means coming back here with another envelope. What's going on here then? Okay, the AI has had a bit of an altercation, look. Whoa, pal. Pal, what are you doing? What are you doing? Are you insane? Look at this. You know what? That red car just got straight into the van. If only Eurotruck AI would behave anything like this. Look at this. I almost feel tempted to ram the guy. Whoa! You nutter! Oh, man. That felt good, actually. Hang on. Yeah, you riff-raff! If I'd have been in my car, though, I'd have stayed well out of the way. But in the truck, I don't care. You do feel somewhat safer in this thing. Occasionally the AI just does that though. It just does really insane things. And I think that's great, it's funny. Could perhaps do with a few more vehicles on the road though. We'll probably kill the lights now. Given how sunny it is. Get ourselves up to a nice safe 100. And then what did we order? We ordered a radiator, leopard skin, seat, covers, dashboard, a wheel. Was there anything else? I'm trying to think now. It was a little while ago. Definitely the radiator I remember ordering, which means we're going to have to refill with coolant, by the way, when we fit it. Oh boy. I swear that's that red car. It's gone the other way. Whoa, 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 get off the dirt. I love how this thing's just chucking out plumes of smoke in the back. Like, it's the 90s. We don't care. Emissions. What are they? We're just starting to think about emissions. Everything was just so much more basic, you know? Fuel injection, sounds nice. I'm half expecting the police to be here. I don't know if the police turn up though when you're in your truck. Honestly don't know. I can't get over spending $1,000 on fuel though. That is unbelievable. I swear it was cheaper in the 90s than that. Stay away from him. Look, he's got plumes of smoke coming out the back as well. We're almost doing 100. We're doing 115 then, going downhill. Almost at the limit. Definitely time for a beer. I can't see what I'm doing. I hadn't noticed that when the guy drinks, he basically blocks his own vision completely. I dare say that's not a mistake. Do you know what? My house is like through there, but annoyingly you can't cut through. You have to go all the way down here, then kind of double back. Okay, this is us. Let's make sure there's nothing behind us. That'll do. Another successful trip to town. It's working out alright. Of course, we're going to need a lot more money if we're going to do the bigger stuff. Like, once we go to the mechanic, honestly, everything is just so expensive at the mechanic. Like, ask him to knock out the panels and straighten them, and it costs a fortune. I think the roll cage, I can't remember, the roll cage is about 5k, I think. It's a lot of money. In some ways, this game is like extremely grindy and tries your patience. And that puts a lot of people off. But the flip side of it is, you kind of feel like you've earned things, you know? When you build that car, you feel like you've earned it. When you order parts, and then, you know, you have to wait for them to come the next day, and then you have to pay for them with money that you've got by grinding wood chopping and poop jobs. When you get that part and fit it on, it's satisfying. And that's the thing, if stuff is like really easy to come by, then it loses its meaning completely. Whereas if you have to work hard to get things, then you cherish them more because there was so much more personal input invested. That's the word I'm looking for, personal investment. So when you get it, you're like, oh man, that feels so good, man. And that's the one thing that this game does deliver, even though it is at times buggy. I mean, only the other day I was playing it and I got out of the truck near the mechanics and fell through the floor. I just literally fell through the floor and appeared back in my house. You know, I had to restart the game to fix that bug. That shopping bag on a previous episode, I went to put it in my larder and it, what did it do? Pinged off down to the bottom of the driveway. You know, it's got glitches, it's got bugs. The AI is a nightmare. It'll try and kill you. But I don't know. It just makes me want to play it because it is so darn hard. And it does make me chuckle when I see comments about mosquitoes driving people crazy. Because that is honestly, like, the least of your problems. Okay. Let's reverse it up. Parking brake is set. Ignition is off. We are home. With the booty. Pooh. Doesn't say fragile on the box, so we're good, right? Well, this is more like DHL. To the door. Or parcel fast. This is parcel fast. I'd be putting it on the floor and just kicking it along here. That seems to be the way to deliver. Whee! Another one there. Boom. Let's get the bag of stuff. Because we really don't want this exploding in the back. Now we will need to take... Will that not go through there? What a scumbag game. We will need to take the diesel and... I can't believe that. It's outrageous. There we go. Put that over there. Let's grab the mozzie spray. We'll leave one on the counter. I think we've got one on the car. I can't remember. If not, we'll leave one in the car. Try and leave some drink and mozzie spray in the car. In each vehicle, sorry. That way, we can always have a drink and we can always get rid of those annoying mozzies. So we'll leave one in here. This, which is the new one. That's the one that's used. Let's take that one. I think there's already one in the back here. So yes, this one can go probably in the tractor. Or just leave it here for now. It's weird I can hear mosquitoes when I've already sprayed mozzie spray. Right, let's unwrap stuff, shall we? Let's have a look what we got here. What's this? Ooh. Looks nice, but I think I ordered a wheel, so that's probably not going to fit on the wheel. That was a waste of time. Yeah, we got ourselves a racing wheel. But this only go... I don't think this goes on the racing wheel. I think it'll only go on this. But we'll have a quick look. If I can convince it to... Come on, game. I had it then. There it is. Yeah! Why is my seat bouncing? Why are you bouncing? Crate of beer. It's glitching you out. That's why. Yeah, we've got a racing, but we need the spanners to open that. What have we got in here, then? Ooh, dashboard cover. Leopard. Leopard. Now that is something. What's this one? Oh, the seat covers. How could we not go with the seat covers? It works with the yellow, I'll give it that. It's horrendous in a nice way. Let's pop that. Let's get this open. Let's get that open. Toolkit is not in here, apparently. Must be in the boot. Okay, it's in the boot. There it is. Now then, what do we need for the... Let's turn that round. Now, what is it for this? Is it a... Blah, 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 blah. I'm going to guess at a 10. I think it's quite a big one. Oh, like a glove. I actually guessed that. Not even joking. Sorry, Mr. Wheel. But you've been relegated. to the racing spec wheel. Yeah, like I say, I don't think this, can we get that cover off though? I don't think this fits on here, but we'll try. No, I'm not getting the option. That's the only downside of the race wheel. Bit annoying, to be honest. We'll leave that on there, because it kind of looks funky. I like it. Oh, you'll just refuse to when I throw it. That's interesting. Used to that. Nice little decorative ornament. Right, to do this, I think... Ooh, seven? Let's try a seven. Now then, do we just... Let's get inside the engine. Let's undo that. Should be two on the other side here somewhere, I think. I'm guessing. Was it four that we put on this thing? It's really awkward trying to see them, though. I think that's one of them, but I don't want to undo the wrong one, you know? Oh, man, the visibility is real. Come on, into the engine compartment. In you go. There should be another one down here somewhere. Maybe it's just three? That doesn't seem right, considering I just did one up here. Where's that other one? It was down there, wasn't it? So one, two... Is that ready to come off here? No, it won't come off yet. Which means there's another one somewhere. Let me have a look at the radiator. That might give me an idea. Let's have a look at the rad. Because it will have the same. Okay, one, two. Three, four. Because it goes like that, doesn't it? So yeah, there is another one here. There's definitely another one there. It's just getting visibility onto it. There, I can see it. There it is. Awkward or what, eh? Out she comes. In goes the race spec red. Oh, yeah. Had it then. Okay, let's try and get forward and lean in. One more. Apparently I'm knocking a bottle around somewhere. One there. Should help keep the engine a bit cooler. Okay, game. Please jump up. Thank you. Oh, the camera is unbelievable. Let's double check that's definitely in tight. Yes, it is. Okay, right. Coolant then. I'm going to use the coolant. I know this is a brand new coolant, right? So I'm going to put that up here. I've got a feeling that's a new coolant as well. So I'm going to take this one. We're going to use that one first. Actually, don't know if there's any left. But we're going to find out. I don't think there is any left by the look of it. No. Okay, you can go in the bin. Yeah, first time I was trying to pour this coolant in, I was thinking, how do you unscrew the cap on this thing? Of course, you don't unscrew the cap on this thing. You do on the diesel and stuff, but not on this thing. You just pour it like that. I'm not sure if one is enough, but we've got a spare one, which is why I bought another one, because it's quite a big radiator. It does look like a GTX 1080 radiator, doesn't it? Like the cooling thing on a graphics card. Wow. The question is, will it completely fill it? The answer is yes, it did. So let's assume there's some left in that. So we'll put it down there. Let's put the cap back on. Okay, let's fire up, make sure it's all okay. Should be. I see why it wouldn't be, but you know. Let's just make sure here. Now, you know what? That small racing wheel is actually interfering with my view of the dials, which I'm not mad keen on. Let's get it warmed up here. This is the mixture coming up as the engine gets warmer. Get it nice and warm. Sounds nice enough. Definitely. Yeah, it's just starting to settle up there. We're going to replace the carbs anyway, so I'm not too worried about the mixture. Gonna have to redo all that again anyway. Move this beer out of the way. Let's get rid of this old red. There's nowhere to put the thing is you can't sell scrap parts at the moment, so there's just literally nothing to do with this. We'll just put it around the side of the house. But yeah, there you go. What do you think? I'll tell you what I'm wondering, why I've got such a bent front piece there. Because I don't know how that happened. I honestly don't know how that happened. But we're going to have to get that straightened out. I honestly, when did that happen? I don't get it. Anyway, that's what the Wasp looks like right now. I think the yellow interior really works with the yellow bodywork. I'm liking what's going on here, apart from the stubby bit on the front. That's looking beautiful. Inside is just looking, look at that. Just look at that. Awesome. New wheel, new skins, new rad. Rad man. But yeah, that's going to have to be the end of another episode, I'm afraid. Because my guy needs to go to sleep quite badly. So we better go and get that done. Save that. He's hungry. He's very tired. What time of day is it, actually? I've completely lost track of time. Okay, 4:15. That's not too bad. Dirtiness level is up. Food is... Actually, let's have some macaroni. And let's go and get clean to end the day. We'll end the day with a nice sauna. It's been quite a busy day. Quite an exciting day, I would say. How many saunas have you seen me have in this game now? Quite a few, I suspect. Let's close that. Keep the temperature up in here. So yeah, what's on the agenda for next time? Well, bottom line is we need some more money. We've got $7,000. But I think the first thing we need to do is get our order in. Well, tomorrow we need to send... It's too late now for today. Tomorrow we need to book a new order, take it up to the shop place, and order any more parts. But I also want to take the car down to the mechanic and spend some money get it straightened. Now, the difference between the mechanic and the shop is that the mechanic will want the money there and then, whereas the shop will happily take an order and then pay on delivery. So, you know, it's quite different in that sense. So I think what we'll do is we'll make an order, we'll drive the car around to the mechanic, and then decide what repairs we want to get done. And then depending on how much money is left, decide whether to post... In fact, we'll post the order anyway, what we're talking about, because we can always pay it when we've got the money. But then we are going to have to come back and do a lot of jobs. There's no way around it. We're going to have to do work again. And considering we have no jobs at all on the board, we've completely cleaned the board out. The only way to get more jobs now on the board is to stay here. And because we're always out and about, we're never catching the phone calls, which is a bit of a problem. Which means the only thing left is either wreckage collection or wood. They're the only two that we can do. Anyway, that's for the next episode, guys. Until the next one, take care. Give me a like if you enjoyed the video, and happy driving.